Dobar dan, lijep pozdrav i dobrodošli na press konferenciju uoči utakmice 16. kola HT prve lige između Hajduka i Gorice, koja se igra na stadionu na Poljudu u nedjelju sa početkom u 17 sati i 5 minuta. S nama su trener Valda Zambrauskas i naš igrač Nasiru Moro, koji će nam pomoći malo najaviti ovu utakmicu, posljednju ovoj godini i posljednju ovoj polusezoni. Coach, last game in this year, in this half season, what is the condition of the team ahead of this last game in the series?
Well, condition of the team is great. Mood is an atmosphere in the team is great. Of course, we're looking for this biggest challenge of all, last game of this year. But you know, when you are in the good mood and you are in a good rhythm and you're playing good, you would like, you know, this holiday not to come and to carry on. But of course, the rules are rules. You know, we need to be concentrated, to be focused for this last game, and then go for those couple of weeks of deserved rest.
Do we have any injury problems or?
We do as always, you know, like this is part of the football team and part of the process, you know, like one or two injuries always there, but you know, again, as I always repeat, we have a squad which is much more bigger than 11 players, and I think we're proving that time after time. And you know, like if we have Nasiru here and he didn't play for some games he was not even in the team sheet, and then he comes on and plays one of the great games, and that shows, you know, that the players, they understand the system, they understand what is demanded of them, and they are ready to contribute and ready to execute the tactical plan as we decide that we want to use in this game.
Yeah, we had a great game against Osijek, one of the best teams in the league. Now again we have a opponent, one of the best teams in the league. Hajduk doesn't have great results this season, but Hajduk is always Hajduk.
Hajduk is always Hajduk, you know, like those big teams with a tradition, with history, with pride, with sweat and blood in their t-shirt, you know, they always ready and they always can produce a result when maybe nobody expects them. So sometimes not about the players, but about the t-shirt, tradition and pride that carries them on the pitch, and they by no means we can underestimate Hajduk, and we respect them a lot, and we respect their fans and their history. But of course, we want to create our own history, and you know, like we cannot hide. We want to win. We want to win. I always repeat, you know, the most important thing is to concentrate on what is about the plan and the execution and how we have to play, like we did against Osijek. That was a great win, but as always, all those big wins go to the history very fast, so we can make our own history only if we repeat this type of results consistently. So now we go to Split, and we feel we are ready, we feel we are prepared. Of course, you cannot be favorite on Poljud. Hajduk is always Hajduk, but we believe in ourselves, and we believe that we're going for 3 points there.
Okay, Nasiru, let's hear some few words from you. How do you feel? What is the atmosphere in the team after this big win against Osijek?
Yeah, just like what coach said, you know, the atmosphere, you know, in the club is really, really high now, and everyone is really good. And even after this game against Osijek, everyone is happy, and the training, you know, level is going high, and everyone has a very, you know, big demands ahead of us, and we are all ready for this huge game coming.
Yeah, we don't have very nice memories from our last visit to Poljud. Can that be a little bit more motivation for all of you?
Yes, of course, you know, because for now we are in a very good direction, and as coach said, you know, Hajduk is always Hajduk, you know, it doesn't matter, but we also, Gorica, so we are going there as, you know, underdogs, but we are not going there just to say hi to Hajduk. We are going there, you know, in the business terms, you know, and everyone is ready. We are going there for a very important game.
Yeah. Yeah. What do you think about Hajduk forward line, their attackers, who is maybe most dangerous in this team?
Yeah, for as a player, I can't just, you know, mention individual because everyone, they are all good. They are all good, that is why they are there. So, and for me as a defender, I'm always ready to face anyone that will, you know, come across my way. Yeah.
Okay, great, thank you, Nasir. Last question for the coach. We have this last game, and what is the plan after that in this nearest future?
Well, like for most of the teams, I think all of us, all first division will go for holiday. We coming back on 4th of January, and then we're planning to spend like some week here, then to go on a training camp, and only already, you know, like around 20th of January we will restart the season, and in spring there's more games awaiting us than this first part of the season because of some cancellations. So it's really difficult time ahead of us, but I think we, with the team that is growing, we have a lot of young players who I believe they developing some of them faster than probably we expected. But I'm very, very confident that they will keep developing, the team will keep growing, and I think you know, good times are waiting for Gorica next year.
Ok, thank you guys, good luck tomorrow. Eto, s tim ćemo i završiti ovu najavu. Dakle, sutra u nedjelju Gorica na Poljudu protiv Hajduka, 17 sati 5 minuta, posljednja utakmica u ovoj godini, sjajne godine za Goricu, sjajne polusezone za Goricu. Nadamo se, evo, kao što i trener i Moro kažu, da ćemo u istom ritmu nastaviti na proljeće.